Hi, I'm Mark Bailey. I'm an application engineer here at Agilent Technologies. Today I'd like to talk to you about optimizing your throughput through test systems and specifically using the digital multimeter and setting up the multimeter for fastest measurements. In general, one of the things you can do when you set up a test system is make sure that you group the different functions together that you're going to be measuring. By that I mean if you're going to be measuring a DC voltage measurement and then a current measurement and maybe a resistance measurement, it's a lot better to put those all together. Take all your DC voltage measurements together, then change the voltmeter, make your resistance measurements, and so forth. This will cut down on the overhead and all the switching that goes on inside of the multimeter, so you'll be able to go much faster. But I'd like to talk more specifically about the multimeter. I have a 34410A. I'm going to talk to you specifically about the five different things that you can do to speed up the multimeter and make its optimum measurements. This instrument actually is capable of making 10,000 readings a second, so we're going to see if we can get to there. So let me go ahead and turn to the multimeter itself. It comes up in an auto mode with a lot of digits of resolution. It's in auto range mode and so forth. We're going to change some of those things. So I'm going to do that using the internal web browser that's built into the 34410A. I've gone ahead and connected to that just through a LAN cable directly to my laptop computer. So again, everything I'm doing is just using the internal web server that's built into the 34410A. So let me go ahead and make some adjustments to the instrument using the laptop. Okay, so I'm into my control mode on my 34410 using the internal web server and my laptop. So first things to notice, the default settings, it's in DC volts, it's in auto range. Auto zero is on, peak measurement is on, it's taking 10 power line cycles to take the measurement, or about 167 milliseconds to take a measurement. So if I want to take 10,000 readings a second, which I've set up my sample count, that's going to take forever. So I know there's some things I want to change. One of the first ones to change is going out of auto range and going to a fixed range. This is so that my instrument doesn't get confused and jump around between ranges, which would slow it down. Internal to the 34410 is something called peak mesh. And it actually is regularly at 50,000 readings a second taking a AC measurement. So I'm going to turn that off because I don't want that running in the background. It slows things down. I want to change the integration time. Instead of 167 milliseconds, I want to slow it or make it go much faster. So I'm going to select 0.006 power line cycles, which translates actually to 100 microseconds. So theoretically, it could go 10,000 readings a second. However, I also have auto zero on. Auto zero actually takes a measurement of the input and then takes a measurement of an internal short, and it goes back and forth and back and forth. This gives you a really accurate measurement, but because I'm taking a burst of measurements over a 1 second period, I'm not going to worry much about drift and so forth. But actually, before I change that, let me go ahead and apply this and show you the problem with auto zero on. If I go ahead and start a measurement, it actually beeps at me because it can't do it as fast as I wanted it to do. And then you'll notice it takes about 6 or 7 seconds for it to get the measurement made. Okay, now I'm going to go ahead and turn auto zero off, apply that to the instrument, start a measurement again, and you'll notice it's a whole lot faster. Okay, it took like 1 second to take my measurement that time. Okay, now I supposedly have 10,000 readings in storage. Let's take a look. I'm going to want to look at all 10,000 of them, so I punch in 10,000 for the number of readings to get, and I go ahead and get the data from the internal memory. And sure enough, it turns out there's 10,000 readings there. Okay, I can capture those readings by doing a control A to get them, a control C to copy them, and I drop them into my Excel spreadsheet. I paste the readings. There they are. And if I now just highlight and plot the measurement itself, you'll see that when I do that, I see the data plotted out that I captured. Okay, so we've just optimized the 34410 for the fastest possible reading rate. We've turned auto zero off, we've set to a fixed range, we've changed the integration time to a very low 100 microseconds, we've set trigger delay at zero, we've turned off peak measurements. And if this was one of the older instruments, we could even turn off the display, because sometimes this display being on slows things down. If, on the other hand, you're making AC measurements, there's other things to consider. There's a low-pass filter in there that's typically defaults to 20 hertz on the 34410. It could go as low as 3 hertz, but goes even slower. There's also a 200 hertz rating, and so to get the maximum reading rate out of the AC, you go to the 200 hertz setting on the AC filter. So hopefully this will help you get a higher throughput through your digital multimeter. Thanks for listening, and I hope you learned something out of this.